Hi guys, as always, before I get into this video, I just want to give you another quick update about how Jake is actually doing. Because it's the first, and as I said in my announcement video for my giveaway that I uploaded last night, he has just gone to the vet or the hospital. He went about 8:30 this morning and he was very upset because he couldn't eat anything. But he'll be there today and tomorrow he will be having his operation. So either tomorrow or the day after we will know what's what. And of course I'll let you guys know about what actually happens. So fingers crossed it all turns out really, really well. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is David and today I am going to be doing my wrap up for January of 2022. I recorded this once already, but my phone just said no, I'm not going to upload and you can't make me, so I am doing this for a second time, so this is take two. So before I tell you what books I have read and DNF'd, I went into this month because of the state of what Jake is actually going through. I wanted to read smaller books because I didn't want to get into something more hefty and then having bad news and having to be in a reading slump. And as a result, I have read 11 books. So before I get into this video, please do not forget to subscribe, ring that bell, and give this video a thumbs up. I will also have a link down below to my Goodreads account in case you want to check me out on Goodreads. But let's get to the things that I am currently still reading, and that is Slash. This is his autobiography. Slash is the leading guitarist or the lead guitarist of the rock band Guns N' Roses. I'm slowly making my way through this. It's going to take me a while, and yeah, it's really cool. But this one will be bleeding into this month. And the next thing that I'm reading, which was an impulse buy when I went to my bookshop the last time and I was looking at the mangas and I saw this. This wasn't on my radar, it was just recommended to me by a staff member. And that is Kaiju number 8. This is the first volume and I'm really enjoying this. This is a fun little manga and I'm looking forward to talking about this one. So I had one DNF last month and that was the remaking. This is about witches and many years later they have a movie based on them. I got about halfway through this and I wasn't enjoying it. The characters in it were unforgettable, unlikable, or really, really dull, and the plot wasn't really that much to write home about as well. It was really slow and uninteresting. I could have pushed through this just for curiosity to see what happened at the end, but I didn't want to force myself to. I might hold on to this one and give it a reread at some point, but I might let it go. And yeah, it wasn't that fantastic. So let's get to the things that I actually read last month. And the first one being Pride Be Damned by Ellen Boyd. I did this as an author request video, and the video is on my channel, so it will be linked down below in case you want to check it out. This was an absolute pleasure to read. This is a contemporary story which has drama and thriller elements scattered throughout, about a boy who has to find his kidnapped father and to kind of overcome his sadness for the loss of his mother. And it's really, really cool. It's a YA book and I cannot wait to read the second book, which will be happening sometime this year. But I rated Pride Be Damned by Ellen Boyd a 3.5 stars out of 5. Next is Interview with the Vampire by Anne Rice. I picked this one up after learning about the author's death. And this is a fantastic vampire story that is kind of set and grounded in reality. It was a really interesting book. It's not overly gory, but you do sympathize with some of these characters, even though they are supposed to be evil and they do have an uncontrollable bloodlust. I will be doing my best to go on to book 2, which is The Vampire Lestat. But I rated this book a 4 stars out of 5. It was extremely enjoyable and a fun book to actually get through. Also, I have actually done a video on this book as well, so in case you want to check it out. Next one was a poetry collection by Jeremy Fee, and that is called Eclectic Nightmares. I've done a whole video on this, and I also did a giveaway for that book as well. Even though I don't read much poetry and I still have no idea what to make of it, I know what I like and I know what I don't like. But this was an interesting book. It wasn't the best thing ever, but it's more of a thing which you can read while you're waiting for a bus, or if you want to read something in a short amount of time, this is it. But I rated The Eclectic Nightmares by Jeremy Fee a 4 stars out of 5. And as some of you may be aware of, I am slowly making my way through of all of Edgar Allan Poe's work. I have done a whole playlist dedicated to that new series where I review every single one of his tales separately. And I'm also going to be bunching a few of his poems together when I get to them and reviewing them as well. I've called this brand new series The Year of Poe. And the first one that I read in the collection I have here is the Unparalleled Adventure of One Hand's Fall, about a man that goes in a hot air balloon up to the moon to escape the troubles of his life on Earth. It was vintage science fiction. It wasn't the best, but I appreciated for what it was trying to do. I rated it a 2 stars out of 5. And the next story that I read, which I am going to be uploading hopefully on the same day as this, is The Gold Bug as well. This is an adventure story where a man gets bitten by a golden colored bug and he is obsessed about going on this quest. This was slightly better, as I rated this a 3 stars out of 5, and I cannot wait to continue on with Poe's work. Next is The Blood Beast Mutations by Khaw John Lee. This is about a virus that was inspired by the coronavirus. And this is about a man that has to go to the hospital to find and be reunited with his sick wife. But along the way, he has to overcome trials such as protesters that are trying to kill him, and also all these creatures that burst out of victims' chests and try to eat other people as well. It's really short, and I was nearly going to give it a 5 stars, but I wanted to be fair because of its size, so I give it a 4 stars out of 5. Next is Nothing But Blackened Teeth by Cassandra Khaw. This is about a group of individuals that go to a haunted house over in Japan to get married, and they find themselves tormented by a spectre called the Bride, who torments them and tries to drive them mad and insane. It wasn't the best, but I appreciated it for what it was. I will be doing a video review on this, so I'll be able to go more in depth about my thoughts and feelings regarding this. But right now, I have rated this a 2.5 stars out of 5. Next is The Ocean at the End of the Lane by Neil Gaiman. This focuses on a man who goes back to his hometown to attend a funeral. And while there, he goes to a farm and remembers a girl that used to live on this farm and a pond that she constantly refers to as a ocean. This is an extremely complex story to talk about, and I'm not even sure whether I'm going to be doing a video on this, but it's kind of a world within a world. It is fantasy, but this is extremely, not confusing, but it's really hard to explain to someone. But I enjoyed it for what it was, and I give it a 3 stars out of 5. Next was the novelization of Ghostbusters. If you've seen the movie, you've pretty much read the book. The only difference is that some of the dialogue and some of the events that happened in the movie happen in this, but in a slightly different way. Slimer, instead of being green, he is yellow. Also, the place where the Ghostbusters store all the captured ghosts they actually have a screen or a monitor where you can look into the containment place and see all the captured ghosts. But as I said, if you've watched the movie, then you've more or less read the book. I got this after the announcement of Afterlife, which was fantastic. This was an enjoyable read, even though I'm really familiar with the movie. As this wasn't really much different from the movie, I feel comfortable about letting this go and, yeah, watching the movie instead. But I had really a lot of fun reading this, and I give it a 4 stars out of 5. If you're a fan of the movie and you happen to see this one in the shops, then yeah, sure, pick it up and give it a read, but know that you're not going to get much difference between the movie and the book. Next is a manga by Junji Ito, and that is Dissolving Classroom. This revolves around a brother and a sister. The brother is obsessed about apologizing, and everyone that he does apologize to, all their brains melt out from their face, their nose and their mouth, and they slowly die and dissolve. And the sister is totally insane, and she is obsessed about eating all this melted human waste. And this is a short story collection. I will be doing a video on this, and as it's fantastic, I really had a lot of fun reading this. And I will be going super in depth with my review for it. But long and short of it, guys, this is the first 5-star rating for a book on my channel for 2022. This was fantastic. It really was an absolute joy and pleasure to read this. And then the last thing I finished was The Beauty by Aliya, Whiteley. As you can see, I got this one at a reduced price. This is one I found in one of my favorite comic book shops / bookshops as well. And I was browsing through all the shelves and I saw this one in the sales section. I read the back of it and I enjoyed what I read on the back. So I thought, okay, you know, it sounds cool. It's only £1 and if I don't like it, it's no massive loss. This focuses around a group of guys who are sitting around the campfire every single night, retelling stories about the past and the present, and more specifically, tales about all these women which have died mysteriously by this fungus. And on their graves, there are all these strange mushrooms growing, and one day, one of the storytellers, called Nate, encounters a woman who is completely yellow and is covered with all these mushrooms, and they fall in love, which I thought, okay, yeah, you know, this is weird, but it is sweet because I'm a very romantic guy. It kind of went downhill after that, after it was described that they had sex. So I thought, okay, it's still romantic, but it's a bit weird. But it completely lost me when one of the guys in this got pregnant by a mushroom baby, or with a mushroom baby, rather. It's really short. In this, it does actually have another story called Peace Pipe, which is about 100 pages long, the same length as The Beauty. But because I didn't really like this story at all, it was extremely boring and dull, despite it being weird as hell. But I found myself having to push through it. I was debating about whether to read the second story or not, but I think that I will give it a miss. I think I will just pass this one on, and maybe the next person will find some more enjoyment out of it. But yeah, this was a disappointment for me. So I had to rate this a 2 stars out of 5. It wasn't that amazing. So that's it, guys. That is my wrap up for January of 2022. If you have read any of these, let me know. If you want me to do any video reviews for any of these books, let me know and I will oblige. And with all that out of the way, have a great day, read some awesome books, and I will see you all in my next video.